So in this part of our tutorial, we're going to see how we can add a login page and authentication to our website. Right now, we want to start with a new project inside of a new folder, and we're going to create a simple login and authentication system using Django, and then we're going to use that inside of our current application where we can log in and then visit the data related to our classmates. To do so, let's create a new window here inside of our VS Code, and we're going to continue our work from here. So let's open a new terminal right over here. Let's make it bigger and let's create a new directory, mkdir, and then the name of our folder can be login, so cd login. And now we're going to create a virtual environment just as we did for the other project. So now let's run python 3 vnv. Sometimes we should also use -m, but right now let's try it with this one. And so we're going to write the name of our virtual environment. So we can write anything. We can write the name of our project, Django login. So now I repeated the process with -m and it works. So make sure to use -m as well. And now let's cd, or we can first run the command ls. And as you can see, Django login has been created. So let me cd to Django login. And now we can write code dot in order to open a new window containing the folders of our project. Oh, it says, so I think it's code space dot, and now it will open up a new window containing the folders of our project. So right here, let me open a new terminal and now let me make it bigger for you to see here. And we can cd to bin, cd bin, and right here we can write source dot backslash activate, and as you can see, it's been activated. Now right here we should install Django another time because it's inside of a new virtual environment. So we can run pip install Django. So now as you can see, it's been installed, successfully installed. So let me run clear so that we can have a clear page. So right here we can create our new project, Django admin. Django admin start project, and then we can write the name of our project. I can call this login project. So let's wait a little bit and you will see that a new folder has been created and the name is login project. So let's cd to login project. Oh, it's a misspelling again. Okay, so something clear. So cd login, and it's underline project. Okay, there we go. So let's open up here. As you can see, we have Python, we have manage.py, so we should use Python manage.py commands and start our project. So first of all, Python manage, oh, it's again misspelling, Python manage.py. And first of all, we don't need any migration, but let's migrate. Okay, as you can see, we had something to do right here. And now we should run python manage.py Python manage.py run server. And by the way, this port is in use because another project is up and running. So let me stop that. It's right over here. Oh no, right here. So let's here press Control C. And by the way, if you want to have the two projects up and running, you can create a new port and run it on that specific port. But here we don't need to do that. So for example, you can run Python manage.py and then you can run, for example, run it on port 2000. But right now we don't need to do that. So we stop the other server and make this one run one more time. And as you can see, that port is not in use anymore. So let's open it up. And here, as you can see, we have our Django project up and running. Just the same as what we had in our previous project at the beginning. We had this rocket right here. So we need to develop with our project on our project and see what we can do. Also, let me close all of these other extra windows so that we can start working on this. So press Control C so that you can stop the project or you can stop the server. Now we can run, actually we can develop on our project. So here we have a folder containing some files here. Also notice that we haven't started the app. We want to work on this project without starting any applications because our main focus is on the login. So first of all, we need to check our settings.py, and here let me minimize our terminal, also run clear so that it becomes clear of the commands. And here inside of our settings.py, you should check that we have Django contribute.auth here. This is related to authentication, and if this is not inside of our installed apps, then we will not have our authentication systems. So we need to make sure it is right here, or if for any reason it's been removed, make sure you add it to your installed app. Now the next thing we should do is to head over to urls.py, and here we need to add a couple of things, such as include here. We need to import include from django.urls, and by the way, these two are unknown here, so we need to check whether we have Django already installed. By the way, it should be installed because otherwise we wouldn't have all of these folders created. But let's check Django admin version, Django admin dash dash version, and as you can see, it's installed and we have it up right here. So we need to find out why these two aren't actually working. So now for creating all of the login pages inside of the urls.py, we should write path, and then right after it, we should write accounts. And by the way, this should be inside of the apostrophes. By the way, there are double C's. So, and then we should include, by the way, we have imported the include right here. We should include Django contrib.auth.urls, and this will create all of the URLs necessary for logging in and logging out. So now here we should also create a templates folder in order to create a template for our login forms and also logout. So here inside of the login project folder, I'm going to create a new folder by using mkdir for or make directory for the templates. So here I can write templates, or yes, templates is okay. And then I can cd to templates, and then here I can create another directory for login. So I'll make directory and call it login. Or it's better name it registration. Registration. Okay, there we go. So we should also create some other files for the templates, which we're going to cover in the next part of our tutorials. And we're going to talk about all of the details and what we should write inside of our HTML files and how we can style them with CSS. Also, how we should manage our backend. So till the next video, goodbye.